The one silver lining, if you will, that we are beginning to see is that we didn't have that extraordinary pounding of torrential rain for those hours and then have several more days of it, which we could have seen that.
Right. Harvey was a longer event. Of course, it had more rainfall and it affected more people, but still, that doesn't diminish the harder hitting amount of rainfall in a shorter time, but it seems like it was as strong or maybe even stronger at times as far as the intensity of it for a shorter time over a small area.
We actually have a kind of a dry air mass that's helped us out here,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, dry air mass moving on in from the east, higher pressure building on in from the east, and that's going to help dry us out as we head on in towards the weekend. Right now, don't see much of anything. There's some ground clutter over towards Lake Charles, but over southeast Texas, we're good. Futurecast going to show some showers coming up tonight. We'll keep a 20% coverage. I think it's going to be mainly along the coastline towards daybreak as we get a little bit of convergence. Still, it's a moist atmosphere. Don't get me wrong, but we don't have the tropical moisture over us. Typical stuff for this time of year, maybe a little below normal coming up tomorrow with about a 20% coverage under partly sunny skies. Can't rule out widely scattered showers and maybe a thunderstorm or two, but nothing like what we saw over the past 2 to 3 days in southeast Texas. So our forecast for tonight looking at least like isolated to really widely scattered showers and partly cloudy skies, a 20% coverage, temperatures in the low to mid 70s and a southeasterly wind off the Gulf of Mexico. And then for tomorrow, looking at partly sunny skies, about a 20% coverage of showers, maybe a thunderstorm, and high temperatures into the mid-80s. A lot of moisture on the ground, so temperatures won't be quite as hot as you would normally think this time of year. That's about normal, a little bit below normal because of that moisture in the atmosphere that keeps us a little cooler. Otherwise, Sunday, going to ramp it up to a 30% coverage because there's a little surge of moisture coming in off the Gulf of Mexico. More to work with, a little more cloud cover, high temperatures close to about 87. Then Monday, Tuesday, look hot and dry, as high temperatures will be about normal for this time of year, maybe an isolated shower or a thunderstorm, and partly cloudy to mostly sunny skies, drier air filtering on in, and that's good news. We need it to evaporate all that moisture off the ground and help further dry out our situation. Then on Wednesday, about a 40% coverage, and then by Thursday and Friday, looking like about a 50% coverage of showers and thunderstorms, another surge of moisture moving into southeast Texas off the Gulf of Mexico. As far as the tropics, the next 7 to 10 days look good for southeast Texas at this time.
But it's good that we get some dry days in there.
We really need it. That's right.
More rain.
We've got to dry or get all this flood water out of here, and that's going to help.
Yeah, we've got to get it dried up. Thank you so much, my friend. We appreciate it. We know you're putting in a few hours here these days.
Nah.
Quite a few hours he's working hard for you, my friends. Thanks a lot, Patrick.